Today we're exploring what it means when we say Jesus is Lord of the Dance.
So, let's get dancing. Well, hello everyone, and welcome to CAMSA Connect, a worship service brought to you by the Cambridge Citadel Salvation Army family.
We hope you've had a great week and that you're ready to share in some worship with us today. Coming up, we've got a special guest appearance from a new CAMSA Connect character. We introduce to you two new members of the CAMSA family, and we've got music from our junior choir, The Singing Company.
Well, as you can see, today's theme is Lord of the Dance, and we're heading back to John's Gospel to look at the second half of chapter 15, where Jesus talks about the vine and the branches.
As usual, members of the CAMSA family are helping us, and we've got some time for the children today. Plus, in an episode with dance in the title, there'll be opportunity for you to stand up and stretch your legs later on too. So let's get things underway with a hymn which declares that God is love, let heaven adore him.
Thank you. Dear Lord, thank you that you are good and your mercy endures forever. Thank you for coming down from heaven to teach us how to love one another. We love because you first loved us. Help us to show our love to our friends, our family, to strangers, and even people we may not like. Thank you for always comforting us and being in this day before us. We praise you and give you glory. In Jesus' name I pray, amen.
I will offer up my life in spirit and truth, pouring out the oil of love as my worship to you. In surrender I must give my every part. Lord, receive the sacrifice of a broken heart. Jesus, what can I give? What can I bring to so faithful a friend, to so loving a King? Savior, what can be said? What can be sung as a praise of your name for the things you have done? Oh, my words could not tell. Giving up your life to death, even death on a cross. You took all my shame away, there defeated my sin, opened up the gates of hell, and have beckoned me in. Jesus, what can I give? What can I bring to so faithful a friend, so loving a King? Savior, what can be said? What can be sung as a praise of your name for the things you have done? Jesus, what can I give? What can I bring to so faithful a friend, to so loving a King? What can be said and what can be sung as a praise of your name for the things you have done? Oh, my words could not tell, not even in part, of the debt of love that is owed. Of the debt.
Well, thank you for sharing in prayer. May each of us be willing to offer up our life as a gift to God today and every day. Now, the song Lord of the Dance was written in the 1960s by English poet and songwriter Sidney Carter, and it's sung to an American shaker melody called Simple Gifts.
Yeah, and it tells the gospel story in the first person voice of Jesus, who says, I am the Lord of the Dance. The dance being Jesus's life, starting with him coming down from heaven to earth and ending with his ascension back to heaven, something we observe this coming Thursday, actually, Ascension Day in the Christian calendar.
The song is a beautiful way of describing the gospel story. We imagine that God's love is the music and we are the dancers. Everything we do needs to be in time with the music. In other words, our lives need to be in tune with God's love. That's what Jesus meant when he said, abide in my love. He meant stay in it, live it and breathe it.
That's right. So just as dance expresses music in physical movement, we have to show God's love in action by loving each other. Well, later on we'll hear that song, but first coming up we're going to have music from the singing company and some time for the children with one of our young people's workers, Phil.
First though, we'd like to introduce you to two new members of the Cambridge Citadel family who have come to us during lockdown. Thelma and her son John are from Enfield Citadel Corps.
John is a junior soldier, a football enthusiast and a musician, and we'll see him in the singing company in just a moment. And Thelma is an occupational therapist for Cambridgeshire County Council. They moved to St Ives just up the road a few months ago. Don't forget to say hello to them in the video chat if you can.
Well, here are Thelma and John with a quick hello. Then we're going to have a song from the singing company which reminds us, no matter which town we are from, God reigns over all, is there for us and looks after us.
Hi everyone, my name is Thelma and this is John. We moved to Cambridgeshire, we're not living in St Ives. We've come from Enfield Citadel. We're very happy and really hoping and waiting to meet you all. Can't wait. Come
here. Every second, every minute, every hour of every day, you're the ever-present God throughout the years. Every village, every city, every road along the way, you're the God of everywhere and always here. You are the Lord God Almighty. You are the Lord God Almighty. You
ruler of all the earth. Morning, people. This morning, we've been thinking about Jesus being the Lord of the dance. So I wondered, what makes you want to dance? When in your life have you wanted to, or been made to, dance? It may have been when you've been asked to do it for a recording, like these guys. It may have been when you've won something, like these football players and managers. Nobby stars his jig after winning the World Cup with England in 1966. Luton manager David Pleat after his team saved themselves from relegation in 1983. And Crystal Palace manager Alan Pardew celebrating his team scoring against Manchester United in an FA Cup final. Have you ever had to dance at school? Say, country dancing or Morris dancing? I remember a few times that I've had to dance in my life. At a Harvest Festival barn dance at the hall. I've been known to do a few ceilidhs in my time. And every Easter morning, I have a little dance, just like David. And of course, at my wedding. Aww. So, why do we dance? I guess mostly it's because it's an expression of joy, of happiness, just like those football managers. In the Bible, in Psalm 30, David wrote that he will praise God because he has turned my mourning into dancing. Basically saying he was sad, but not anymore, because God was with him. David explains why, and those reasons are still the same for us today. Call on God and he will help you. God's favour will be on you always if you trust him. Although things might upset us for a while, God still promises us joy in the end. So, when you've got something to be happy or excited about, or you just want to express yourself, don't forget that you can always have a little dance. Dance to your heart's content. Dance like no one's watching, except maybe God.
Well, thanks, Phil, for reminding us that we can be ourselves before God, and that includes a bit of dancing from time to time. Very nice moves, by the way.
Well, coming up in the next segment, we're going to introduce to you a new character here on CAMSA Connect by the name of Seamus O'Leary.
Yes, he's a short-sighted Irish farmer, formerly of the soft metal country crossover tribute band Def Shepherd.
And with the help of some Irish dancers from within the CAMSA family, he'll be leading us in a song. First, though, let's join together in the online offering and then we'll head over to Norman for the weekly update.
Thank you for your giving in our online offering today. The amount given last week was £142, for which we are most grateful. In the video description below is information on alternative ways of giving if you are unable to use the online version. Good morning, everybody. By now, you will have received your prayer leaflets for May and your army papers. Please remember to pay for your periodicals and your cartridges, of course, in the usual way, by sending a cheque to Karen or by bank transfer. In our weekly officers update, which has now reached number 60, there is information from Territorial Headquarters about Thy Kingdom Come, which is an invitation to join with churches for 11 days of prayer from Ascension, which is this coming Thursday, the 13th of May, through to Pentecost on Sunday, the 23rd of May. While on the subject of prayer, this update also identifies many people and situations with folk in or associated with our core who need our prayer support at the moment. Every Sunday on this same video channel is Kids Time at 9 a.m. followed by CAMSA Connect at 10 a.m. which next week is a special episode for Candidate Sunday. There is no brass reflections this week, but keep listening out as there will be one in May. Prayer Matters is at 7 p.m. on Wednesday, followed by CAMSA Connect Sings, which is at 8 o'clock, but not on this video channel. This week it will be featuring songs from Salvation Army musicals. Thanks for watching and for listening. Now, here on CAMSA Connect, we like to do things differently, and the next item is no exception. In fact, I'm pretty certain that you will not have seen anything like this on our YouTube channel ever before. Are you ready? Take it away, Seamus.
In the morning when the world was begun, I danced in the moon and the stars and the sun. I came down from heaven and I danced on earth. At Bethlehem I had my birth.
Dance then wherever you may be, I am the Lord of the dance city. And I lead you all wherever you may be, and I lead you all in the dance city.
I danced for the scribe and the Pharisee. They wouldn't dance and they wouldn't follow me. I danced for the fishermen, for James and John. They followed me and the dance went on.
Dance then wherever you may be, I am the Lord of the dance city.
And I lead you all wherever you may be, and I lead you all in the dance city. I danced on the Sabbath and I cured the lame. The holy people said it was a shame. They stripped me and whipped me and hung me high, and left me there on the cross to die.
Dance then wherever you may be, I am the Lord of the dance city.
And I lead you all wherever you may be, and I lead you all in the dance city. I danced on the Friday and the sky turned black. It's hard to dance with the devil in your back. They buried my body and they thought I'd gone, but I am the life and the dance goes on.
Dance then wherever you may be, I am the Lord of the dance and he.
And I lead you all wherever you may be, and I lead you all in the dance and he. They knocked me down and I jumped up high. I am the life that'll never ever die. I live in you if you live in me, for I am the Lord of the dance, said he.
Dance then wherever you may be, I am the Lord of the dance, said he.
And I lead you all wherever you may be, and I lead you all in the dance, said he.
Dance then wherever you may be, I am the Lord of the dance, said he.
And I lead you all wherever you may be, and I lead you all in the dance, said he.
Well, well done everyone for joining in that bit of craziness. What about that? Some people actually can do Irish dancing.
And frankly, some can't.
Maybe not.
Anyway, thanks for joining in the fun. And we say thanks to Seamus O'Leary and his friends Foster and Alan for the song.
Well, no doubt that received mixed reactions. I wonder what Trevor and Daphne thought of it. Hello, CAMSA.
Hi, CAMSA.
What do we think of Seamus O'Leary?
Oh, we love him.
We love him.
Love him.
We love him very much.
Love him.
Well, we should go in to preach the word one Sunday.
Oh, yeah, preach the word.
Right. Anyway, everyone, it's time to head back into John's Gospel and explore a bit deeper what all this vine and branches stuff is about and how it applies to us living our lives here in the 21st century.
So in a second, with the help of the New York Staff Band, we'll join in the singing of a song. First, though, let's hear the verses we're looking at today. To read them for us, here's Alexandra.
John chapter 15, verses 9 to 17. As the Father has loved me, so have I loved you. Now remain in my love. If you keep my commands, you will remain in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commands and remain in his love. I have told you this so that my joy may be in you and that your joy may be complete. My command is this, love each other as I have loved you. Greater love has no one than this, to lay down one's life for one's friends. You are my friends if you do what I command. I no longer call you servants because a servant does not know his master's business. Instead, I have called you friends, for everything that I have learned from my Father, I have made known to you. You did not choose me, but I chose you and appointed you so that you might go and bear fruit, fruit that will last, and so that whatever you ask in my name, the Father will give you. This is my command. Love each other.
I overheard Michael Ball interview Wendy Holden last week on the radio about Captain Sir Tom Moore and his book Life Lessons. And Michael mentioned this particular quote that the captain is said to have made One small soul like me won't make much difference. Now, of course, here in the UK, we know that actually he made a real difference to the life of this nation. He raised more than £32 million for the NHS, and he only started out to raise £1,000 by walking 100 laps of his garden. He was made an honorary colonel. He was knighted by the Queen. He had a number one with Michael Ball and has written 2 books and started the Captain Tom Foundation. And all of that is done at the age of 100 and a bit years old. And so it made me think about how many times we say things like, I can't do very much, I've no gifts or talents, or even I'm too old. One small soul like me won't make much difference. And then I thought, if that's possible for someone like Captain Sir Tom Moore, how much more possible for those of us who are in Christ to do great things? And so what do we believe about what we can do? Are we Philippians 4 people? I can do everything through him who gives me strength. Or maybe we're Matthew 19 people. With God, all things are possible. Now, there are important words to note there. Through him and with God. In other words, we can do nothing except with God. David Cusick has written this. It isn't that the disciples could do no activity without Jesus. They could be active without him, as were the enemies of Jesus and many others. Yet they and we could do nothing of real eternal value without Jesus. So if we want to see real eternal value to what we do, then we have to look at John chapter 15 and we have to learn about what it means to remain in him. It means reading his word, actively spending time with him, so setting aside time to listen, to worship, to invite him to come and sit with us a while. And of course, I want to add to that attending church, which for some of us at the moment means online worship. And as we do, we find that our lives, attitudes, even our very character is changed from glory into glory as we grow to be more like him. Because if we don't, well, Jesus actually says it very clearly. If you are not attached to the vine, that's Jesus, then the branch is thrown away and it withers and dies and then it's taken up and burned. It's not of use. It has no life, no green shoots, not even the promise of green shoots. Burned means, of course, we all know that something then is turned to ash. Now here's the thing, folks. We know what God has done for us. He sent his one and only Son into the world because he loved the world. So not only should we, who know him, want to meet Jesus in our eternity, but shouldn't we want that more than anything else for those who have not yet received salvation, who do not yet know the great love he has for them? And of course, the fruit then of that love is that we share it with others. And in fact, it's not even that we'll have to go out of our way to love. It will just be a natural thing within us, a natural byproduct of us remaining in God. Now, you may remember from last week that Martin said that we are to love people even when what they do is unlovable. So I want you to listen to this quote. Saint Jerome says that in his extreme old age, when he used to be carried to public assemblies of the believers, his constant saying was, "Little children, love one another." His disciples, wearied at last with the constant repetition of the same words, asked him why he constantly said the same thing. "Because," said he, "it is the commandment of the Lord, and the observation of it alone is sufficient." So remaining in him is of vital importance. And the fruit of remaining in him is love, even when it is hard. And when it's hard, then we go back to him, because in him, nothing is impossible. We can do all things. You see, we don't need to necessarily be like Captain Sir Tom Moore. We are just expected to, in our tiny corner of the world, person by person, show the love of Jesus. So as you think back over this last week, how well have you loved? Have your fellow human beings seen the fruit of love in you this week? And if not, maybe this coming week you need to do better with remaining in the vine. The prayer of St. Patrick says this: Christ with me, Christ before me, Christ behind me, Christ in me, Christ beneath me, Christ above me, Christ on my right, Christ on my left, Christ where I lie, Christ where I sit, Christ where I arise. My words, remain in him. And then the fruit of that is this: Christ in the heart of everyone who thinks of me, Christ in the mouth of everyone who speaks to me, Christ in every eye that sees me, Christ in every ear that hears me. So may that be our prayer today, right this minute and for all the days that follow, for surely we want for the whole world to know that salvation is of the Lord, salvation is of the Christ. So may your salvation, Lord, be ever with us. Amen.
Christ be with me, Christ be for me, Christ behind me, Christ within me, Christ below me, Christ above me, Christ be with me. At my right hand, at my left hand, as I lie down, as I stumble, as I fall down, Christ, as I stand, Christ in the heart of everyone who thinks of me, Christ in the mouth of everyone who speaks of me, Christ in every eye that sees me, Christ in every ear that hears me.
Lord God, thank you that your love is like a dance that everyone is invited to join. Teach us to work together to help each other like partners in a dance. Whatever our differences, may your love be the music that brings us closer to you and to each other.
Lord of the dance, as we go out into the world, help us to follow your steps and invite others to join in. In your wonderful name we pray. Amen.
And amen. Well, thanks everybody for joining in this week. Please do like the video if you did, and consider subscribing to stay up to date with all of our video content. We'll look forward to seeing you next week when we celebrate Candidate Sunday, a day where we think about how God calls ordinary people into the extraordinary life as a Salvation Army officer.
Our theme will be Out of This World, and we'll have music from our senior band, plus we'll be hearing from our own officers in training, Gavin and Mary from Cambridge Citadel, who will be ordained in just a couple of months. Where has that time gone?
It's gone very quick, hasn't it? Fantastic stuff. Well, as always, we'll conclude today's worship with a song, and this one asks God to show us how to love each other. A great prayer for us all. So until next week, everyone, keep safe, keep well,
and keep connected.
God bless you.
near